Hey everyone, Mark here. Happy Wednesday. Welcome to my channel. Welcome to this video. I hope I'm speaking a little bit louder. I take all of your comments to heart. I take them seriously. Enjoy them as always. But I did have somebody reach out and say, I don't know if it's my phone, but Mark, I haven't really been able to hear you on the last couple of videos. And I think that's because I record a lot of these late at night when my family's already in bed upstairs. So I do try to keep my voice down, which really doesn't make for a good experience. And I apologize to any of you that had that difficulty. Hopefully you can hear me nice and clear now. So I am going to do, it's been done a few times. I wasn't actually gonna make this video on this particular release because it has been done by a couple other channels, but then I had somebody reach out to me last night and ask me and say, Mark, you gonna do a review on this album? So I have to, and I'm glad to do it. It is of this album, Elvis Presley, Burning Love, the RCA rehearsals. I actually had Ed from the Kinks Court. He went to Infinity Records. He was able to get a copy for me as I wasn't able to get out on Saturday to get it. I actually was scheduled to work. I had taken the day off in hopes of getting to it, but the day just slipped away. Ed was able to get a copy for me. He mailed it promptly, and I got it yesterday. When I put it away, there must have been like a slight nick because part of as you can see, the plastic did tear. But we will open it. I will see if I can get this hype sticker off. I've heard a few people say that the hype sticker is very difficult to get off. Yep, and there it goes, it rips. You know what, I'm not gonna worry about it. People are saying, Mark, you gotta keep the hype sticker. Yeah, I have them for all my FTDs, but yeah, like I said, this one's ripping, and I actually read a comment yesterday where somebody said they couldn't get the hype off either. It's affixed so well that you just can't get it off. So what I might do actually, in fact I will, I'll just keep part of it. I've seen people do this. I think Ed's done this too. I will just keep this part of the sticker inside of the sleeve just so I have it. So yeah, that's what we'll do. It won't be affixed to it, but there's the hype if you can see it. So what's the hype say? Record Store Day, April 22nd, 2023. Elvis Presley Burning Love, the RCA rehearsals. 2LP 50th Anniversary Edition includes 25 tracks from Elvis's historic 1972 RCA studio recordings, produced by Ernst Michael Jorgensen and mixed by Grammy Award-winning producer Matt Ross Spang. So I'll keep it. I'll just keep it on the inside. So cool cover. I do really like this cover. Apparently this is selling for big money now on eBay, which, come on. I think they made less than 4,000 copies. I'm not a big fan of this picture of them, but I do like these. You got the cover of Burning Love. You got the, looks like advertisement for this, a couple singles. Separate Ways, Always On My Mind. Then the advertisement for that single down here. So pretty cool. Oops. So what I thought I would do, I haven't done this in a while, is I'm actually going to put it on the turntable. So yeah, I'm actually gonna do it. I'm gonna maybe the powers that be at YouTube might block it, but hopefully not. But there is the vinyl. Feels like it's heavyweight vinyl. Orange label. I'm not seeing any smudges or anything like that. Looks pretty clean. Now my spin on of being safe, there's like a slight big old piece of. You gotta love that's the thing about, I gotta get some Mylar or some sleeves for these. I gotta get some, order them from Amazon or maybe, but pretty clean looking label. So I'm gonna put it on the turntable so you can all hear the first song. First song we will hear will be Burning Love, take 3. So I'm gonna pause this video here and I'll be right back with you.
Okay, we're rolling. We take 2.
Yes, if you want to do it again, E.
Feel
I want to tell you, it sounds really nice. Really, really nice acoustics. Elvis's voice is front. Foremost, once you hear it, sounds really good. Sounds a lot like the master, actually. At the recording sessions. I think that's from the August, like the early part of 1972 or the August shows at the Hilton Hotel in Vegas. Yeah, it sounds really good. I've heard several people say how great it sounds, and it's no joke. It sounds really, really clean, very clear. Like I said, it kind of punches you in the face a little bit. It sounds really good. I love the studio chatter.
Yay! That's great. We're rolling.
Okay, anytime.
All right, here we go.
You're feeling lonely.
Kind of cool. There's no ending into the next song. It goes. It's like consecutive. I like that.
Upon my pillow.
All this sounds amazing. The background vocals sound amazing. The instrumentation sounds amazing. This is a home run, in my opinion. This is it actually sounds even better than I thought it would. I've heard, like I said, I've heard from other channels that have played it. I've read the comments that it sounds really, really nice. It does. It's no joke. It sounds so, so good. So, yeah, if you're able to get this and you can get it at a decent price, you know, get it. Add it to your collection. I initially was not going to get it. And as the date got closer to record store day, I kind of switched gears in my head. I thought, you know what? I got to get it. I just love to hear the process. You know, Elvis in the studio talking to his bandmates. It's definitely a home run. What you can probably do, I believe if they have any left over, you can search it, Google it, see what other record stores out there in the United States that has it, and go to their site. And you might be able to get it at a cost if they have any left over. Because I know you had to be in person on record store day, which I found out the day before. You had to be in person to get your copy. They couldn't hold it for you. Because I was going to prepay for mine and pick it up. They couldn't do it. They have an agreement with record store day that you have to be in person. And then whatever's left over, if there is any leftover stock, you can order it online as of the next day. So that would have been Sunday. So, but like I said, Ed from King's Court was good enough to get a copy for me. And I'm glad to add it to my collection.
Sooner we can get it over with, the better.
See, this is okay. Ooh, this is a good one. Wait so you can hear it. Oop. Probably know now.
Maybe I didn't treat you.
Love this song.
Quite as good as I should have. Maybe I didn't love you quite as often as I could have. Little things I should have said and done, I just never took the time. You were always on my mind. You were always on my mind.
I just want to give you a little sample. If you're on the fence about it, if you don't have it, if you do have it, I know you're enjoying it. I do want to thank all my new subscribers, those who have commented, have reached out. I appreciate each and every one of you. If you like this channel, or what you've seen of this channel, please consider liking and subscribing so I can grow it and get more content to the masses. So, hope you have a great Wednesday. Stay safe out there. We'll see you next time.
Girl, I'm so sorry, I was blind.